Hey everyone! Today I made a slip cover for my sofa using a vintage linen bed cover that I got from my aunt. And because of the shape of this sofa, I was able to make the slip cover without losing time in doing the pattern before. To start, I lay the fabric onto the sofa, covering the entire surface and edges. This cover bed has two nice finish edges, so I'm placing it onto the sofa with one of the finish edges facing the front of the seat. Then, using pins, I pin the fabric on one corner on the front of the sofa, making sure the fabric is lined up in both sides. On the other side, I'm folding the extra fabric on top of the sofa so that I can trim the extra, leaving enough fabric to cover the edge. So now I can pin in place the fabric on the other corner. As I did before, I fold the extra fabric on top of the sofa, leaving enough fabric to cover the entire back, and then I trim the extra. To start giving a shape to the slip cover, I'm pinning the fabric on the back corners as I did on the front. Then I cut the fabric on both side edges where the sofa opens. I pull the fabric tight and I mark along the back side edge. Then I trim the extra fabric. Here I'm pinning all the parts together. Then I'm cutting a square from the leftover fabric to sew in the opening. I just repeated the same process on the other side, and with the fabric inside out, I sew all the parts together, starting from the top. I'm sewing the two sides together with straight stitch, and after I'm using zigzag stitch to serge the raw edges. Thank you. After sewing all the parts together, I'm trimming the extra part of the fabric along the bottom edge. Now I'm trying the slip cover inside out on the sofa to check if it fits okay. Luckily it fits great, and now I can pin also the two front corners. I'm sewing the two sides together with straight stitch along the pins, stopping 2 cm far from the end, so that I have enough seam allowance for hemming the bottom sides of the slip cover. I'm not hemming the front of the slip cover because it has already a nice finish edge. I trim the extra fabric and serge the raw edges with zigzag stitch. Then I just repeated the same process on the other side. Then I hem the raw edges with straight stitch by folding twice the fabric as I saw. I saw the end of the corners that I left unfinished before. With the leftover fabric, I was able to make also 2 pillow covers. Let me know if you would like to see how I made them. Now let's put the new slip cover on the sofa so you can see the final result. It was my first time making a slip cover, and I can say that it was an easy and quick DIY to make. So I hope my video can be helpful if you're planning to make one too. Thanks so much for watching, and see you at the next project!